Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to Anime King. And today I'm gonna be giving you part 20 of What If Naruto Went Missing for 4 years. Get this one to 100 like as usual, share to all of your friends on your social media platform, and also I posted a new episode of Uchiha Naruto the Sage on my second channel, so go ahead and enjoy. And also after this I'm gonna be posting What If Naruto Was Taken by the Raikage, so enjoy that as well. And if you're new and this is the first time you hear my voice, what are you waiting for? Go ahead and click that red subscribe button and join the anime making family and be a part of the channel. And thank you all for your support and help. And without further ado, let's get straight into it. Start the intro. You can change. You satisfy the last time we left off, everything at the village was cool and normal. Naruto became a jonin and they had a party at his house, a pool party, because the Namikaze compound possesses a pool. After that, Naruto and Sakura woke up in the same bed. Katara put them in the same bed last night after the both of them were sleepy after the party. They woke up and they headed to the market. Naruto then sensed something as he turned around, as he couldn't believe what he was seeing. Sasuke? So yeah, that was basically last how we left off, but you guys can go ahead and check it out for yourself and enjoy. So let's start this new episode. Sasuke? Said Naruto as he was confused, as Sasuke was charging towards him, cutting down every villager in his way with his sword. Sasuke's attack, combined with his speed, was so fast that the villagers didn't even feel his sword going through them. He was a distance away from Naruto when the first one felt the pain and fell to pieces. Naruto quickly pulled his own sword as he jumped in front of Sakura. Naruto and Sasuke's sword impacted as the two old friends fought for control for a second. Sakura, like everyone else, was confused as she then noticed the lines of dead body that were cut in half, man, woman, children, lie on the ground in blood-stained pool. Who did this? Thought Sakura, until she noticed that Naruto was facing off against someone. As she saw, Sasuke? Long time no see, dead lass, said Sasuke as he cut down another villager as he jumped back away from Naruto. By now, the crowd had gotten the picture as they ran screaming in all directions. What are you doing here? Asked Naruto. Oh, didn't Ino and her team tell you? Asked Sasuke. I killed Orochimaru to get a real master, and he has given me many gifts. Gifts that has allowed me to kill my brother, and now to return and kill you. Sakura quickly got into a fighting stance, but she then shivered as purple chakra came from Sasuke. It was so dark and evil, it made every hair on her body stood up. How do you have demon chakra? Yelled Naruto. This is demon chakra? Said Sakura. Naruto is red, but he doesn't feel evil as this, she thought. Thanks to my new master, Lord Shaymo, said Sasuke, as Naruto's eyes went wide, as the other three people Sasuke was with started to release demon chakra. In fact, all four of us are demon masters, said Sasuke. Naruto, what is going on? Asked Sakura as she saw a look of worry in his eyes. They are like me. They are demon summonings, but only for the enemy of the Kyuubi, said Naruto. Lord Sheamus is Lord of the Demon Snakes and the oldest enemy of the Kyuubi. It was only wise for him to pick me as his student, since you are one of my oldest enemy dead lass, said Sasuke. I will enjoy killing you and the pink slut before we destroy the entire village. Sakura, get out of here, said Naruto. But before she could speak, Jiraiya and Tsunade landed. We heard everything, and there is no way you little runts can stand up against the legendary Sannins, said Jiraiya. I already killed Orochimaru, and I killed my brother. Killing you all would be a walk in the park, said Sasuke, as he raised his sword, pointing it towards Naruto. However, I want Naruto first. You small fries can deal with my team. That's us, said Sigetsu as he charged forward, each hand holding one of the two swords that he now possessed. I want the Tōtsanin. I will kill the woman, said Jugo as he went towards Tsunade. Looks like I get to kill the girl, said Karin as she headed towards Sakura. Sasuke charged towards Naruto with his sword out as the battle began. The sound of steel sting the ear as Naruto and Sasuke's sword clash. Sasuke, why are you doing this? Yelled Naruto. I was coming to save you. You idiot, said Sasuke. You can't save me from something that I want. You have no ideas what power you are messing with, said Naruto as Sasuke smiled. All I care about is power and I have it now, said Sasuke as he ran through hand signs. Fireball, fireball jutsu! Naruto dashed out of the way of the building-sized fireball that engulfed an entire store, burning it to ash. As the demon chakra and the demonic power made Sasuke and his group about 10 times stronger, smoke rose all over the village, making the ninjas of the village come towards the battle. What's going on? Asked Ino as she looked up at the cloud of smoke. Near the smoke, Jiraiya was running through hand signs. Why lion's mane? Said Jiraiya as his hair expanded and shot towards Sigetsu, but Sigetsu cut right through the hair. Time to die, old man, yelled Sigetsu. Jiraiya ran through another set of hand signs as he spit out a line of oil that covered Sigetsu. As Jiraiya then frowned as he saw the oil coming off of the kid. As Sigetsu's skin has changed, it no longer looked normal. It was dull gray, and his teeth got sharper, and his mouth got even wider. You seem surprised, old man, said Sigetsu as he gripped his sword in his now webbed hands. This looks like when someone is learning Sage Mode, thought Jiraiya. If someone hasn't mastered the base form of the summoning chakra, they took on the look of the summonings. I need to stop this kid before he does real damage. Even in partly Sage Mode, he does a lot of damage, thought Jiraiya. Tsunade wasn't doing the best against her opponent either. Jugo's arm had changed into the form of a giant black claw. She had punched it a few times, and to her surprise, she broke her finger bones on impact. Jiraiya, what is up with these kids? Asked Tsunade. It is the beginning level of Sage Mode, said Jiraiya. It made them extremely powerful. Don't you know Sage Mode? Asked Tsunade. Yeah, said Jiraiya, cover me, as he bit his thumbs and wiped the blood under his eye, connecting the blood marks, as he then poked the both of his hands together. However, it will take me a long time, and I cannot release my arms once I'm doing it, said Jiraiya. Fine, I will keep an eye on you, said Tsunade, as the Anvu and Jonins jump into the fight. Sakura went in for a deadly punch in Karin's chest, but her arm just bounced off the armor. So you're Sakura Haruno. Sasuke has talked about you a bit. He told me that you're weak and you're obsessed with him, said Karin. However, I am here to get rid of the competition for Sasuke. I was, said Sakura. But this time she pulled her fist back and aimed straight for Karin's face. Not anymore. Sakura's fist slammed into Karin's face as Karin went flying into a wall. As for Sasuke, said Sakura in pure anger, go ahead and keep him. Oh, I will, said a voice from the destroyed shop as Sakura's eyes went wide. What are you? Said Sakura. Back with Naruto, Naruto's body slammed against the wall as he dodged one of Sasuke's fireballs again. You're slow, Naruto, said Sasuke as he stood in a flaming building. No, I have just been setting you up, said Naruto as he raised his finger in a sealing position as the gravity seal are all around Sasuke. The moment the seal activated, the burning two-story building came crashing down. I don't have much time, said Naruto as he ran through hand signs. He slammed his hand down and two puffs of smoke appeared. Out of the smoke came Katara and Sato, who was glaring at each other like they usually do in their fight. Naruto? Said Katara, as she looked around. Sasuke showed up, and now he has a demon summoning contract, said Naruto as the two fox eyes went wide. He also has a team, and all of them possess demon contract. And you want us to fight? Asked Saito. Yes, but not with me, said Naruto. As the two foxes looked at each other, I can handle myself. Go protect Sakura and the others. I will protect the vixen, said Katara. And I will go and do some real work, said Saito. As the both of them headed out, as they did, the building exploded with demon chakra. So, you can handle yourself, Naruto, hissed Sasuke. As he came out of the burning building, as Naruto's eyes went wide. Crap, Sage Mode. How the hell could you have mastered Sage Mode? That took years, said Naruto. Not for a heart that is filled with hate and rage, said Sasuke as he charged forward with incredible speed. Back with Sakura. What the hell are you? Asked Sakura as she looked at Karin. Half her face was gone, replaced with red scales and bright red slitted eyes. The scales ran down her neck as a giant cobra-like hood came from the top of her hairless head and ran to her shoulders. I am going to kill you, hissed Karin as a fourth tongue came out of her mouth. She opened her mouth as two large fangs were showing, dripping with saliva and a purple venom. Suddenly a howling sound was heard as a wing-like chakra in a tornado shape hit Karin dead in the chest, sending her flying in yet to another building. Sakura, are you alright? Asked Katara as she appeared next to Sakura. Yeah, but what was that? Asked Sakura. A part of the demon snake sage form, said Katara. She hasn't mastered completely yet, so we are lucky. It would take at least a five tail to take on someone in the sage form. Wait, that is sage mode. You mean Naruto turns into something like a giant snake when he turned into his sage form? Asked Sakura. No, we are fox, not snakes, said Katara. As she heard a rattling sound fill the air. Crap, she's back. With Tsunade, we need to buy Jiraiya some time for him to enter sage mode. Yelled Tsunade at the team of Anvus. Yes, Lord Hokage, said the Anvu as he pulled his sword and tried to cut into Jugo's arm, but only to have it break in half. Die, yelled Jugo as he went in to kill the Anvu. However, suddenly, sand surrounded him. Sand coffin, said a voice as Tsunade turned to see Gaara along with the sand ninjas who had come for the Chunin exams as they show up on the battlefield. Thanks, Gaara, said Tsunade as she looked towards Gaara, who was standing on the top of a roof with a large force of sand ninjas. Ah, it was nothing, said Tankro. No one can stand up against Gaara. Want to bet? Said Sigetsu as he looked toward the sand. A scorpion tail burst right out of the sand as it rushed to one of the sand jonins, hitting him right in the chest. How the? Asked Kankuro as Jugo burst out of the sand. Jugo came out of the sand. Both of his arms were giant pinchers as a tail came out of his tailbone, a scorpion tail. Demon style. Lightning storm. Jutsu! Shouted Saito as a large lightning bolt, larger than anything else any leaf or sand shinobi has ever seen, hit Jugo, sending him flying back. God, that hurt! Yelled Jugo as blood rushed out of his mouth. How did you hurt him? Asked Tsunade. Sharks and scorpion had a civil war long ago. As such, they only have one type of chakra, water and earth. Said Saito as Tsunade grinned. As such, they can only use that type of chakra and no other. So we have to hit them with your natural weakness, said Tsunade. Hit the sharp man with all of the earth style jutsu you can think of, and hit the scorpion one with all the lightning jutsu you can think of, she ordered. Just as they finished talking, the ground shook a little as Tsunade turned around to see Jiraiya changing as two toads appear on his shoulders. Tsunade watched as his muscles got bigger. He looked kind of better with all that muscle, she thought, as the next form appeared, as his nose got bigger with warts all over it, as his hands and his feet got webby. Well, not so much, she said again. You guys don't need to fear anymore, because Jiraiya the Toad Sage is here, said Jiraiya as he started to build up chakra, as everyone was surprised at the amount of chakra he was building up, while Saito just rolled his eyes. Foolish old sage, your chakra is nothing compared to this, said Saito. What did you say? I am the best, said Jiraiya. You look familiar, have I seen you before? Said Pa as he looked at the strange fox. I thought the fox contract died out, he said. It did, for a low level summonings, not a demon fox, said Saito as the two elder toads' eyes widened. What, a demon fox? The both toads yelled. Jiraiya boy, you summoned us to fight a demon fox? Asked Pa. We can't beat a demon fox, they are around, the most powerful summons. Even Sage Jutsus are no match for them. You're not fighting me, said Saito as he looked at the two enemies that were under attack by the sand and the leaf ninjas. You're fighting the summons of the demon shark and the demon scorpion who are partly in the sage mode. What? Yelp, Ma. We stand no chance against them. You're right, Toad. Luckily, that Naruto has mastered sage mode. And as long as they are in this stupid stage, they cannot beat us, said Saito. At that very moment, Naruto crashed through some stone buildings, sending him to the ground. What the hell? Said Saito, as this confusion was answered as Sasuke appeared. Sasuke had changed. He was now a giant cobra. His legs were gone and replaced with a long tail so that he could slither around. His entire body was covered in scales with a black and purple pattern on his back and his arms and his face. His hair was gone, replaced with a classic cobra hood that went down from the top side of his head to his shoulder blades. His arms now got big like a bodybuilder's and they were full with scales. His armor had stretched to cover his torso as he held one sword in his hand and a shidori in his other. His black and white Sharingan blazed at Naruto, who was now embedded into a cart. Oh my god, said Sakura as she looked at the 11 foot long beast who was slithering towards Naruto. What the hell is that thing? That is Sasuke, and as you can see, we belong together, said a voice as Sakura saw Karin standing inside of the remains of the building. As her setup was just like Sasuke's, but she had a red and black pattern, and she also had a more female figure like breasts, and her arms were not big enough like Sasuke's, and she had the general figure of a woman. She wasn't yet complete, she still had human legs, but they didn't move. All her movement came from her new tail, the legs were just there. You disappoint me, Naruto, said Sasuke as he looked at Naruto on the ground, with his sword raised, prepared to die. No, Naruto! Sakura screamed as the sword came down, but it was bounced back up in the air. What the? Asked Sasuke as he looked at Naruto. His eyes were their normal blue, but they were slitted. But the real change was in his arms. From the elbow down was covered in black fur with 6 inches long claws. Sasuke could see a mark on Naruto's claws where his sword had bounced off. Did you forget that I know Sage Form 2? Growled Naruto as he punched Sasuke back, as Sasuke tripped back over his own tail as he fly back into a building. You may have mastered the form, but you don't know how to fight in it, said Naruto. What are you talking about? Said Sasuke as he noticed Naruto was getting larger and the fur was spreading all over his body. Fighting in a complete different body is weird, and you don't know what it's like to fight around, said Naruto. As Sasuke noticed two black ears appeared out of Naruto's face, at the same moment his legs changed into a dog-like foot. Blonde fur then appeared over his entire body. Naruto picked up Sasuke as he held him up and glared at him as he opened his mouth and they had razor-sharp fangs. As a long blonde tail shot out, as it had a white end that touched the ground, as Naruto's chest was covered in white fur. The closest thing Sakura could think of was that Naruto now looked like a werewolf from the fairy tale book she has read as a kid, only he was a fox instead of a wolf. The snake Sasuke now glared into the eyes of a very pissed off Naruto. "Now, I am going to beat you senseless," growled Naruto. Sakura's eyes widened as she looked at what Naruto has become. A 7-foot tall blonde fox with white fur on his chest. It almost looked like the tattoo on his shoulder had spread all over his body and gave it fur. He was holding up a snake form Sasuke in his claws. "Don't worry, Naruto is fine," said Katara as she noticed that Sakura was worried. "Unlike you, Sasuke, I am used to my sage form," said Naruto in a deep, dark voice as he threw Sasuke into a building. "Now, I'm going to tear you to pieces." But guys, I'm going to be ending this episode right here. If you want the next part of this, you already know what to do. Like, subscribe, comment down below, and turn on that bell notification to stay posted. Remember to share to all of your friends on your social media platform. And also go and check out Uchiha Naruto the Sage. I post a new episode. And after this, I'm going to be posting What If Naruto Was Taken by the Raikage. So make sure to stay in tune and enjoy, guys. So yeah, I'm all for now. Peace.